Hey, my name is Rami Tamimi, and today we're going to be going over the basic measurements of pacing as it relates to surveying. Pacing is the natural step that you take between two points in order to measure the distance. By figuring out how far your distance is in feet using pacing, you can then determine distances between points using pacing. The idea of pacing is counting how many paces you take between two points. Using the number of paces that you've taken, you can then calculate the distance between those two points. You're probably wondering, what's considered a pace? It could vary. It could be every step you take. It could be every two steps you take. The point is, a pace should be the natural steps that you take when you walk. Now, for this experiment, we're going to be doing every single step. However, there are demonstrations of pacing where it's every two steps led by your dominant foot. This is really confusing. I don't like to do this, so we're just going to do every step. It still works, I promise. Don't worry. There are three simple steps that you must take in order to have an accurate pacing measurement. Number one, you need to calibrate your paces. By having a set distance, usually this is 100 or 200 feet, and pacing that 100 or 200 feet, you're able then to figure out how many paces are in a given distance. You should do this several times so that you have a sample of data to work with. If your steps are varying more than two paces for the same distance, you might want to repeat this and make sure your speed is the same and that your distance between each pace are the same. The second step after you've done the calibration and figured out what your pace is, you're going to go ahead and pace between set points. Now, these points should have a distance measured with some other instrument so that you can compare your paces to them. By doing the pace around these points, you're then able to calculate how accurate your pace is. And finally, number three, we're going to go ahead and take all that information, bring it into the office, and calculate what those distances are using our paced measurements. We'll then find the error in relation to the difference between the actual distance between these points. And in return, we should be able to figure out how accurate our pace is, one part in what. Remember, you want to aim between one part in 50 feet and one part in 100. That's typically the accuracy you'll get with pacing. All right, let's get started. What we're going to do now is calibrate our pace. In order to do this, we're going to use a 200-foot tape. Now, you have to figure out how many paces you have in a given distance. The distance that we're going to use is 200 feet because this is a 200-foot tape. It measures out in tenths of a foot, so we'll just keep pulling until we get 200 feet. And what we're going to do is we're going to pull it from right here, and we're going to take it all the way down to the end of the yard. What we're going to do now is we're going to take a chaining pin like this one, and we're going to use it to drive the tape into the ground so that we can start measuring. Okay, let's go ahead and measure out 200 feet. And we're going to go ahead and probably get to the end of our tape here. And it looks like we have. All right, so we're at 200 feet. Now, what we're going to need to do is set this on the ground. We're going to put another chaining pin here to indicate where the 200 feet lie. Now that we have our tape all set up and the two chaining pins are exactly 200 feet apart, we can begin calibrating our pace. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead, start out at zero, and we're going to work our way down to 200 feet. Ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75. I've taken 75 paces in 200 feet. So now the thing is, you don't want to just stop here. Yeah, you've done the calibration test and you know you've got 75 steps in every 200 feet. However, it's very important to do this multiple times. That way your accuracy is going to go up because now you have multiple samples of this test. We're going to go ahead and do this three more times. Now go ahead and walk all the way back, come back here for a third time, and then I'm going to return back one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. For the second time I did this, I got 76. The first time I got 75. This is why we do this multiple times, so that we can average our paces. All right, two more times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. Okay. Here are my results. For the first run, I had 75 paces for every 200 feet. For the second run, I had 76 paces for every 200 feet. For the third run, I had 77 paces for every 200 feet. And for the fourth run, I had 76 paces for every 200 feet. That means after trying this four times, my average pace for every 200 feet is 76 paces. So we're gonna use 76 paces to calculate how far of a distance we are between three points. All right, now it's time to pull everything out and start measuring between points. All right, so I went ahead and I set three points. I set a green point, I set a blue point, and I set an orange point. Now these points are quite a bit apart, but what we're going to do is pace between them to get an estimate of how close they are to each other. I'm gonna go ahead and take the liberty and measure between these points using my tape so that we have a baseline to compare our pace measurements to a tape measurement. And this will help us calculate how much error we have in our pacing. Now we're going to do this clockwise from green to orange to blue, and blue back to green.
I accidentally left out a very important detail. After going forward between all of the points, we then need to pace backwards, going from green to blue to orange, and orange back to green. I did this in the field, but I never recorded it.
After we've collected our data, we can then bring it into the office, and using our pacing, we're going to figure out how many feet are between these points and compare that to the measured distance that we got with our tape. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39. 1, 2, 3, 4, 30, 31, 32, 33, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. All right, that's it. That is the field collection for our pacing experiment. Let's head inside into the office and analyze our data.
Hello, and welcome to my office. Now, we're going to take a look at all the data that we collected and figure out what our error is going to be. As we had mentioned in the calibration, in the first attempt, we got 75 paces. In the second attempt, we got 76 paces. In the third attempt, we got 77 paces. In the fourth attempt, we got 76 paces. That means we average approximately 76 paces per 200 feet. That means on average, if we're taking 76 paces every 200 feet, our skill factor is going to be 2.63. Or for every pace that we're taking, we're traveling 2.63 feet. So this is very important because this is what we're going to use to convert between paces and feet. So let's go ahead and take a look at the amount of paces that we took between the three points. So when going forward between green and orange, we went 39 paces. We went backwards 40 paces. And that gave us an average of 39.5 paces. Between orange and blue, we traveled both forward and back 33 paces. So that means our average is 33. And between blue and green, forward we went 19 paces. Backwards, we went 20 paces. So our average is going to be 19.5 paces. Okay, so to get the distance, we're going to need to multiply our paces by the scale factor. Remember that 2.63 number that we got earlier? So in doing so, our distance between green and orange is 103.95. The distance between orange and blue is 86.84. A distance between blue and green is 51.32. Okay, so here are the true distances that I measured. So I used the tape to do this. So I measured this to the nearest tenth of a foot. Between green and orange, I was getting 102.5 feet. Between orange and blue, I got 85.6 feet. and between blue and green, I got 50.6 feet. So now we gotta take the difference between the true measured and the calculated measured through pacing. Between green and orange, I got a difference of 1.45. Between orange and blue, I got a difference of 1.24. And between blue and green, I got a difference of 0.16. It's pretty good. All right, and now, with these differences, we're able to calculate the accuracy. So now to calculate the accuracy, we're going to be taking the true distance divided by the difference. And it looks like here between green and orange, our error is 1 part in 71 feet. Our error between orange and blue is 1 part in 69 feet. And the error between blue and green is 1 part in 71 feet. That means our overall error for the entire project was 1 part in 70 feet. In order to ensure that you did a good job, you need to be above 1 part in 50 feet. 1 part in 70 feet meets the standard. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you learned something. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll see you next time.